accident just before 5:30 this morning. And a village cricket club from Gloucestershire is heading to Windsor Castle today to play a match against the royal household. Gotherington Cricket Club is celebrating 50 years since it was reformed, and the club's secretary, Edward Gillespie OBE, was able to set up the occasion. Chairman of the club, Brian Cosgrove, says organising it has been very interesting.
We're going in not through the normal gate, we're going through a private entrance into their private grounds, so we've had to provide passports or photographic ID. We have to advise the Metropolitan Police and the royal household themselves. It's taken quite a lot of organising, but hopefully it will all be worthwhile.
That's the BBC News for Gloucestershire. More
7:25 sports news coming up in just a bit. First, though, a village cricket club from Gloucestershire is heading to Windsor Castle today to play a match against the royal household. Gotherington Cricket Club is celebrating 50 years since it was reformed, and the club's secretary, certain Edward Gillespie, who you know, was able to set up the occasion. Heather Simons has been to find out more about the club and its big day.
The knock of bat on ball, the classic sound of summer, and a sound that's been heard in Gotherington for over 100 years since the village team has been there.
Hi, Rob Sharp, a player for Gotherington Cricket Club. The best records that we could trace go back to 1888, when there was a game between Gotherington and the Hairdressers of Cheltenham.
And how do you know about that game?
Through the archives at the Echo. To the best of our knowledge, we had a glorious time in the 1890s, and Gilbert Jessop, who was an England Test match player, he'd be the modern sort of, Andrew Flintoff and Joss Butler rolled into one, played for Gotherington in the 1890s. Probably stopped, as most clubs did, when the First World War came. Restarted again in the 20s and had various stop starts during the 1930s, again stopped when the Second World War started.
Now, you mentioned the war. You had a bit of a famous name come back and play for the club.
There was, yes, Sir Charles Hambrough, who has subsequently, very recently it's come out, has been credited with stopping Hitler and the Nazis developing the nuclear capability as a result of a special operation that he was head of in Norway in the 1940s. So he was subsequently knighted, and Sir Charles Hambrough, and having seen off the Germans and looked after the free world, he then decided to play cricket for Gotherington.
And was he any good at cricket?
I think he was very good, actually. He'd been at Eton and he'd played at Lord's in the match between Eton and Harrow. And he was the president from 46 to 50 of the Gotherington club. And